going back home and I'm meeting like all black people. I was torn into the excitement of wanting to say hi to everyone, but then I have to remind myself, you're in Kenya, and that's okay. Hey fam, what's up? Welcome to my channel. My name is Doris Bonita Walubengo, if you like, but on this channel I go by the name Doris Bonita. I am so thankful to be back on the YouTube channel. I was at home. For some of you know that I was in Kenya, and if you've watched my previous videos then you would know that I was in Kenya, and I went back to Kenya after my au pair year. So I want to talk about the things that have changed or the culture shocks that I got being a Kenyan who had just lived abroad for about almost 2 years. I was in Germany for almost 2 years and then I went back home. If you know that, then you know that I had been adopting the German culture and, you know, just everything German. Like, you know, I was being I had already been culturalized, you know. I kind of picked up really fast, probably faster than most of the people, being cultured, like German cultured. And yeah, there are a couple of stuff that I want to share that were a bit more difficult when I went back home. The things that I had to remind myself constantly, that I'm not in Germany, I'm back at home. I don't know how it sounds to some of you, but yeah, like, it's true, it really exists. And I would like it if any of you also went back home. Maybe you've lived abroad and you went back home and you experienced culture shock in your own country. You can share in the comment section. I'll gladly read them and I'm sure it will motivate people and tell them that they are not the only ones. Like, I am not the only one, right? And this is the reason why I share videos, I share my experiences, I share things I've learned, so that we can learn together. Alright, just push yourself, test yourself, figure out what you like, and find your limits, don't be rigid, always work towards a prime, surround yourself with open minds, people can change. First of it was, I was shocked. It's like it was a mixed reaction of shock and excitement and I don't know, like just a lot of stuff, to see so many black people in one place. And I know what you're thinking. The reason why that was a shock is because the part of Germany that I live, the area that I live mostly, there are not so many black people. And a good example is in all my classes, from the Deutsch course to now university, I'm the only black girl in class. And even in school, there are not so many black people. There are there, but not so many of them. There are areas with many black people, or a good number of black people, and there are some areas that don't have a lot of black people. So there's a culture that we have in the city that I live, in the area that I live, because in the city that I live, I know there are some parts with a lot of black people. So it's not really shocking for some black people, but for myself it was. And usually when we meet on the streets with fellow black people, some would call us colored people, but I prefer black because black has a culture to it than colored people. We would say hi to each other, or like, you know, just do like, hey, I see you, like, hey brother, or hey sis, or just smile at each other and then walk, because we are not so many. So going back home and I'm meeting like all black people, I was torn into the excitement of wanting to say hi to everyone, but then I have to remind myself, you're in Kenya, and that's okay. So that was number one, seeing so many black people in one place, like literally everywhere. I was kind of torn in between saying hi to them and just going, but I had to remind myself it's Nairobi. In Nairobi, we all mind our own businesses. Actually, people say that here it's like that, but here we interact with our neighbors. You can even story tell with your neighbors, like the people you don't even know. It's kind of just a Nairobi culture, yeah. So when I came here in Germany, I had the I was Nairobian, you know. So I was cultured into the Nairobi way of doing things, in the sense that you just mind your business, you're not talking to your neighbor. But then here, neighbors talk to each other. So I had to, another thing was to say goodbye. Like, as you know, if you've lived in Germany or if you're living in Germany, it's very important for us to say goodbye to each other. Sometimes even with strangers, as long as you are together in the elevator, you find that when they are leaving, they're like cheers, and then you're also just like cheers, you know. So I also found myself saying that a lot, and lots of thank you, all of those things, the thank yous and the bye, like, yeah, have a good night, you know. I mean, normally we don't really do that with strangers in Kenya, but I found myself doing that. So that was also another thing. The supermarket. As you know, here we package for ourselves. If you're Kenyan, then you know that in Kenya there are people who package for us. I really had to train my mind. You know, when I landed to Nairobi, I took the next flight to my village to visit my parents. And so the first supermarket I went to was the Bungoma market, the supermarket. And I think even in Nairobi, it's a bit more exposed, more urbanized than Bungoma is. And so I would find myself like packing for myself, and they would look at me and they're like, oh, are you trying to take my job? And I just had to remind myself, oh yeah, you're in Kenya, girl, you're in Kenya. They pack for you. I struggled with that thing for quite some time. I went back to Nairobi and I found myself doing the same thing, but eventually, thank God, I got back to Kenyanized. Yeah, I was de-Germanized. I mean, a bit de-Germanized, but there are some behaviors that just never went. Another thing is how we talk sometimes, like with the tone and all that, I could notice in the social interactions. And there are some ways that we used to talk, and according to me, we were just okay. But now that I've lived here, and I believe I have been more polite than I was in Kenya, when I had people speak like that to each other before me, I found it rude. Like, for example, you know, just a parent screaming at their child, telling them how they will beat them. Like, there is no that talking to a child, like, in a friendly way. I don't know. And I think also being an au pair and getting to interact with kids that close made that sink more. It was quite hard to adopt. And also seeing my mother-in-law just disciplining my nephew every morning, like with a cane, it was just, oh my goodness, I could not take it. I literally wanted to tell him stop, and he might watch this video and he didn't even know, because I just had to remind myself, just like, that's, you know. But yeah, that really made me suffer. But I expressed it to my sister. Sometime I would move out and go to my nephew's place just to take a break from those morning cans, because I believe in talking to the child first, like, a lot. And actually right now, because I have not beaten a child since I came to Germany, I just can't hell, like, I just can't find myself beating a child. And then I was amazed by how hardworking Kenyans are. Really, like, kudos. Like, really, really kudos. We are very hardworking people. I don't know, it's just amazing, right? It's amazing. And probably you're sitting there and you're wondering, like, is this girl crazy or whatever? I think I had been really whitenized. I had been really westernized, right? So I was so thrilled by like things I was never thrilled about, like when I was still at home. And when I see like Kenyans like doing everything they can to meet their needs, you know, the mkokos and the hawking, like these things, really, I don't know if you guys get it. I don't know if I'm just the only one seeing this, but it really, like, it really thrilled me. And I was just praying for people on the street. I think another thing that also contributes to this is my love for God and for his people. And so when I saw how hardworking they were, I was just praying for people. Like, the people didn't know, but I was praying for everyone I was meeting. And I just look at them, and the guys like do not care about sitting there and selling sweets and all. Like, these are the things that I never appreciated before when I lived in Kenya. But because I have lived in Germany and I'm going back home, I appreciated my country even more. And there are a lot of things that I never knew we had in Nairobi, like the things I never noticed. This time when I went back, I noticed, like, this is really funny, or maybe, I don't know, shocking or interesting, I don't know how you find it, but I never knew we had trees in the city center. I never knew Nairobi was that beautiful. Like, I knew it was beautiful, but it was just more beautiful when I went back home, and my love for our country just rose, my love for Kenya just rose. And right now, when I tell you I want to work hard and go back home and invest at home, I truly mean it. Like, that time I would just say probably, but genuinely right now my love for Kenya has grown. And even as I was at home, I was praying for my nation, and I was really praying for it passionately, because I really love my nation and I want to see things change. You know, I want to see that our mindsets are changed, you know, how we do things is changed and all that. Sorry about that. The trousers is just a bit... Things have really changed. Yeah, like I noticed a lot of stuff that I never noticed. And I've also seen that there's so much improvement, especially in the city. And I just have to say, Governor Sakaja is really doing a good job. I don't know what you all Nairobians think, but I saw that he's really doing a good job. And I was passing by the Parliament and I saw this Maasai market there. I was so thrilled. I walked a bit in it, but I didn't really get anything from it. But yeah, it's really good what he's trying to do, empowering people with business and all that. Like, he's really doing a great job. Respect. This one, hey guys, it's not even pride, you know, or I don't know, it's not out of a place of kujisikia or something, but I was scared that I had not used the nganyas for a long time. As you know, Nairobi, how Nairobi operates, you have to get off the buses while they are moving. Like, they will only reduce the speed for you and then you have to get off. I was so scared. I was used to using trains. And with trains, it's so much easy because you have Google Map, right? Then you just know this station, and you don't have to worry. And then the train will stop and then you alight. So I missed my stop twice. Like, I got off before we got to the bus stop that I was supposed to get on because I was scared they would leave me. They will, like, watapita na mimi. And I had to take a motorbike. And it was so disappointing because I was so proud of myself that I did great with the public means, you know. So, okay, I'll just get the door. I think that's Lazasha. Okay, y'all, we continue, right? Yeah, the public means, of course, and also the money. And I had also like adopted the tipping, and I tipped a lot of people. My family will kill me if they find out. But yeah, I tipped like a lot of people. I was just leaving change and I had to remind myself, come on in, girl. Hey, y'all see that African princess? No, she ain't no princess. She a queen.
Hey, y'all. Are you doing a video?
Turn around.
Are you doing a video?
Oh my goodness. Do you see that?
I am like summer coloring. Oh my goodness. It's like summer colors.
Wow.
Hi. Really nice. Wait, are you doing a video?
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Well, hi, y'all. How y'all doing? Don't mind me. I'm going to just be in the background. Wow,
that
was here. Oh my goodness.
Yeah, so let me just finish up and I get back to that girl. Hey, you see her? Like, she's a movie star.
Oh my goodness. Hey. Amen.
Oh yeah, you really are though.
Get out.
Anyway, guys, as I was saying, what was I saying? I tipped a lot of people, but I had to like minimize, like, you see when you take the Bolt and then you're like supposed to give maybe this guy 270 and then you just give them 300 and you tell them keep change.
Wow.
Or you don't really say it, you just give them and you leave the car. And then I went to the prayer mountain while I was at home in Catalonia. I know some of you have had Catalonia. If you're Christian, then you should have had Catalonia. And I remember giving double. Like, okay, I just felt in my spirit. I felt that was the leading of the Holy Spirit to give this guy like double what he was charging me. Like 50 shillings, that's like $5. And I gave him $10. But yeah, that's just a conviction I got. But while I was in Nairobi, the Bolt people really benefited the first week I was at home, and second and third. But then the fourth week, I started, you know, reminding myself, you're Kenyan and you need the money now. As much as you want to tip them, you still need the money because you're here. Well, that's a story for another day, because my plan was to stay for 5 days, but I ended up staying for 3 whole months. It was a tough time, but it was also a good time. I'm not going to get into details on what happened at this time. Maybe in future, I'll unleash one by one, unveil and bring the story, because it's a whole testimony. But for now, I just wanted to share with you guys the different things that I experienced, the culture shock I experienced in my own country after living abroad. After living abroad for 1 year, 6 months, and I'm sure probably some of you are just thinking, just 1 year, 6 months, and she, you know, she's saying she had a culture shock. This is my theory. I think when you stay a shorter time in a place and you have to adopt their culture like real quick, when you go back to your culture, you are more likely to have a culture shock than a person who stayed in the other world for a longer time. That's my theory. And this applies the same to the first time I went back to Nairobi, like when I went to university, when I went to Nairobi. And then I came back home after one semester, I think it was just after 3 months. And there's this house that we used to see, like in my village, like it's a huge one. We even thought it was a story building. And then we are going back home with my sister. This is so funny and weird. I just want you guys to get it. Like, we are going back home with my sister, and the only way we could trace home is seeing this house, right? And you've gone to Nairobi, of course, you've seen longer buildings, you've seen like much more developed things. But now in our mind, because that house was a big deal in the village and it was like a story building, in our mind we had it like it was like the Nairobi houses. We went back home in Easycoach, and then we were trying to look at the house. We never saw anything, so we ended up missing our home. And we ended up alighting at Malaba, like Malaba, Uganda. Like we literally went until the last bus stop because we could not see our home. We could not trace our home because we were counting on that house, on the story house, the beautiful story house that was on the road, close by the road, because we knew that when we see that house, and there's also some bar called Saramana, so we knew if we see Saramana and we see that building, we'll know we're at home. That's like the landmark here. We couldn't see them because they were small. In our minds, they were like these huge things that we are just supposed to see them. But because we had lived in Nairobi, and Nairobi stuff, of course, are like bigger. In our minds, we expected it to be as big as that. But we missed it. We had to take Matatu from Malaba back to home in Kimaiti. Home in Kimaiti Kingdom. And we noticed that after all, the house was not that big. It wasn't that outstanding. Just because we were in Nairobi and we had other expectations. And then we get home and we're looking at the sufurias. You know, the sufurias with the black thing that we cook with the firewood. And the sufurias are like really huge, and we were laughing at them because they looked so funny for us. I don't know if anyone has ever experienced this or if it's just me and my sister, but please share your experiences if you had something close to this or something likely to this. So for me, it only makes sense that I had culture shock when I went back home. Despite staying here shorter, I believe if I stayed here 10 years and went back home, probably it will not be as much culture shock as it was this time round. But I'm just so glad I got to stay at home and got to ride the matatus again and just enjoy Kenya. It's really beautiful, and as Kenyans, we should be very, very proud of our nation and the culture, the diversity, you know. We were in these night prayers and I could just look at us and I'm just like, wow, God is really clever. Like so many of us, same color, same nation, same geographical area, but from different tribes with different cultures, and we are gathered together just to pray, and we are all just like praying in different languages. It was so fascinating for me. Like, I never viewed my country in this point of view that I do right now. So I think it's also really good to travel out there. And dear Kenyans, if you have an opportunity to come abroad and better your life, then do that. Come, you know, work hard, get your money, go home, invest, make our country the better place. You know, I think also being here has really opened my mind, and I can clearly notice what is wrong with the country and what is good with the country. And I really pray and hope that I will be able to empower Kenyans to be critical thinkers, and not just, and this one I'm talking politics, not just being puppets to people, because that's not good for the nation. We must be loyal to the nation, not to the people, because these people pass away, but the nation is there. We are the nation, so we must be loyal to the nation. I don't want to talk about politics right now because I will not finish right now. So guys, I hope you enjoyed, and I don't know, like found something new or learned something. I don't know, whatever you got from this video. I am so thankful you watched until this time, and see you around. Please subscribe, share it with your friends, and see you. Peace out.